I am proud to state that my government has turned a new leaf in ushering in unprecedented reforms and rolling the welfare carpet to the doorstep of the deprived section by empowering them economically, politically and socially. We have put in place an impeccable delivery mechanism of welfare schemes in the form of village and ward secretariats, and at the same time I am very happy to say that we have fulfilled 90% of our promises made in the manifesto in the first year itself and are taking the state on the welfare path. On the 129 promises made by government, my government has fulfilled 77 and 39 are in the pipeline, and the rest will be implemented in due course. However, we have implemented 40 new schemes which were not there in the manifesto. Yes, our efforts are blossoming and bearing fruits. Education, healthcare, agriculture and welfare have been given prominence in my governance, and Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy has been very meticulous in planning of every scheme to the last details, which has helped in the financial assistance going directly into the bank accounts of the beneficiaries without any pilferage or middlemen. Thus, I firmly believe the very purpose of the welfare schemes is fully justified. The welfare schemes are the outcome of the 3,640 kilometers Padayatra covering 134 constituencies of the 13 districts in a span of over 14 months, during which time people of various sections have vented their plight and their small needs to Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy, which were translated into promises that found place in the manifesto. My government has spent 42,000 crores benefiting 3.98 crore people under various schemes during the year. The entire amount was transferred to the beneficiaries' accounts as unencumbered accounts, which does not allow the banker to deduct the money for any old dues of the beneficiaries. Education. The welfare in education, being with the Amma body for the mother, is incentivized for sending her children to school, and my government is the first and the only one to introduce such a measure. Rupees 6,350 crores at the rate of 15,000 each have been given to 42.33 lakh mothers benefiting 83 lakh children under this scheme. The scheme covers students from class 1 to intermediate. After infusing zeal in the mother to send her children to school, the next immediate need of the child was taken care of by Jagananna Vidya Kanuka, wherein kids comprising three pairs of uniform, text and notebooks, bags, shoes and socks are being given as a kit. This has cost 656 crores for 39,70,899 students. The midday meal scheme has been refined by adding taste and variety into the menu, which the Chief Minister had taken personal interest in deciding, in keeping in view the nutrition and other factors in mind. Jagananna Goru Mudda, as the scheme is called, cost rupees 1,11,5.36 crores and about 39 lakh 70,899 students will be testing the generous touch given by the Chief Minister. When the child enters the graduation, full fees reimbursement besides allowance for hostel and mess charges are also taken care of by my government. Under Jagananna Vidya Divana, rupees 3,857 crores was given to over 18.51 lakh students as fees reimbursement. Under Jagananna Basati Divana, rupees 1,221 crore are given to 15.57 lakh students residing in hostels. In two installments, about rupees 2,200 crore will be given. The amount will be deposited in the mother's bank account. In the final year of graduation, the last semester will be dedicated to skill development and internship to prepare the students to boldly face the competitive market, as the student will emerge with better employable skills. This is how education is taken care of from class 1 for professional courses. The most innovative and useful decision taken by my government is introduction of English medium from class 1 to class 6. Nearly 97% of the parents have endorsed this English medium from primary level, though there are some hurdles. There could be some shortcomings, yes, but our government has taken enough precautions by starting bridge course to the students and training the teachers to cope up with the new curriculum. I firmly believe that the introduction of English as medium in instruction from the primary level will be a game changer for the generation to come, as it will be level playing field for the students. I hope good sense prevails over the detractors and the hurdles will be cleared. Under Nadu Nedu Manabadi, in the first phase, 15,715 schools have been taken up for revamping for basic amenities like furniture, fan, toilets, running water, board and chalk, painting, compound wall and English lab will have been built. About 3,387 crores were sanctioned for it. All 45,000 schools will be revamped in phased manner in 3 years. Health. Coming to the health sector, my government has provided oxygen to the YSR Arogyasri scheme, which was ignored by the previous government. The state has spent so far rupees 1,534 crore extending the benefit to 6.25 lakh people. The number of medical ailments covered under the scheme has been increased to 2,059 from 1,059, and it has been extended to 13 super specialty hospital in Hyderabad, Chennai, Bengaluru for 716 medical procedures. Pension is being paid to patient with chronic disease up to rupees 10,000. Hospitalization over rupees 1,000 comes under purview of YSR Arogyasri. Under YSR Arogya Asara, financial assistance of 225 per day and up to 5,000 per month will be paid during the post-surgery recovery period for patients, and the state has spent ₹72.82 crores, covering 1.06 lakh beneficiaries. My government has spent ₹53.85 crore under OSR Kanti Berugu, covering 67.69 lakh students. In the first and second phases, screening was conducted in 60,401 schools. The third phase is in progress. A total of 560 crores will be spent on this scheme in six phases. This apart, my government is planning to start 12,000 YSR clinics near all village ward secretariats and a fleet of 1,060 vehicles of 108 and 104 ambulance service are ready to take up. YSR telemedicine is a big hit where the doctors have a virtual intervention with the patient, diagnose and prescribe medicines. Under Nadur Nedu, government hospitals would be upgraded to national standards, ₹15,337 crores was allocated for that purpose. In adding to the existing 11 teaching hospitals, six more will come up. Agriculture. YSR Raitu Bharosa is the another scheme which has completed its full circle and the second round was begun. Though the promise made was for 12,500 for 4 years, my government has extended it to 13,500 and for a period of 5 years to be paid in three installments, one before Kharif, one before Rabi, and the third during Sankranti festival. The state has spent ₹10,209.32 crores benefiting 49.44 lakh farmers, and ours is the only government to extend the benefit to tenant farmers as well. This was never done before. A YSR Ritu Bharosa Kendra has been established in every village secretariat to cater to the needs of our farmers from seed to sale. We are also establishing 147 YSR agri-testing labs at the constituency level and 13 labs at the district level to increase agricultural production. A price stabilization fund of ₹3,000 crores has been set up to ensure minimum remunerative price to the farmer. The state government has also earmarked calamity relief fund of ₹2,000 crores to help farmers overcome the impact of severe drought conditions in the state. My government is committed to transform the farming activity as a profitable venture by supporting the farmers in all possible ways, especially in case of any unfortunate incident of a farmer suicide. The family members of the deceased farmer are supported by the government with ₹7 lakhs of financial assistance for rehabilitation. My government has paid compensation to eligible farmers who were earlier denied compensation. Housing. My government is perhaps the only one in providing housing site for 30 lakh beneficiaries at a cost of ₹7,000 crore, and unlike the earlier governments, the beneficiaries will know where the plot is and it will be registered in the name of the woman of the household. My government will be providing 25 lakh houses in 4 years, of which work will commence for 15 lakh houses in the August itself. YSR Pension Kanuku was the first scheme to be implemented from Navaratnalu, as the state has paid rupees 14,438 crore to 58.62 lakh beneficiaries, which is contrast to 490 crore per month spent up to January 2019 by previous government. The pension is being handed over to the beneficiary at the doorstep by village and ward volunteers on the first of every month. The old, sick and disabled who had to go to the disbursing office and wait for whole day are now very happy as the welfare schemes being door delivered. YSR zero interest scheme for SHGs has benefited 91 lakh women with rupees 1400 crores, while YSR Bahan Mitra given twice amounting to rupees 500 crores and Agri Gold victims were given rupees 236.53 crores. YSR Matsakara Bharasa was given twice in accounting for rupees 211.70 crore, while under Netana Nestam rupees 197 crores was spent on 81,703 beneficiaries. Other schemes include restart package for MSMEs amounting to rupees 963 crores and loan Nestam. Villages and ward secretariats. The concept itself is to change the rural landscape and decentralize administration by setting up village and ward secretaries. My government has redefined and has given a new look to villages where 60% of the population still lives. It was the Chief Minister's vision that could provide over 4 lakh jobs, which will itself is a second to shuts. This happened just in 4 months after my government took over. There are 11,158 village secretaries and 3,876 ward secretaries, each one catering to the needs of the population of 2,000. There are 10 permanent staff and 40 volunteers to deliver the government schemes to the beneficiaries in each secretariat. All the 50 persons would be locals, which will be an added advantage. Of the total employed 2.65 lakh are volunteers and 1.35 are secretarial staff. The socio-economic ecosystem of the village are changing and changing for good. What you see on entering villages is secretariat for 541 different services with the timelines for each service from ration card to onwards will be available. Ongoing further, there will be a Raitu Bharosa Kendra, which serves as a one-stop center for all agriculture and allied sector needs. Advises farmers on crop pattern, supply of quality inputs, e-crop booking, facilitating crop loans, input subsidy, insurance and facilitating marketing facilities besides buying the produce by ensuring minimum remunerative prices. My government is planning to establish YSR Janata Bazaar to ensure sale of produce of village and ward level itself. If you go still further, there will be YSR clinic with 54 types of medicines which act as a primary referral point for YSR Arogyasri. Adjacent to it will be a school where English will be the medium of instruction from primary level. Education, health, agriculture and marketing as a cluster in every village. This is how our rural areas will be shaping up, and my government is proud to unveil this landscape. The welfare schemes will be delivered by the staff without any consideration of caste, creed, religion or political affiliations, and all eligible persons will get the benefit on saturation basis. The village ward secretary system has brought a sea change in the basic administrative structure, and in the coming days it will further amplify the effect, and I'm sure about it. Women welfare, besides depositing the money for children education to the mother's bank account and registering house sites in the name of the women of the household, my government has taken numerous other measures for women welfare. The zero interest loan would benefit 91 lakh and rupees 1,400 crore was deposited for the benefit of self-help groups. Every group will get from 30,000 to 40,000. ASARA will benefit the women SHGs in clearing the loans amounting to about rupees 27,000 crores, which has been promised in 4 installments at the time of general elections, while the Chautha provides financial assistance to women belonging to scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, BCs and minorities who are in the age group of 45 to 60 years. They will be getting rupees 75,000 in 4 years. To empower women on the political and economic front, 50% reservation are provided in nominated posts and nominated works. Our government has brought in a Disha bill to take fast and stringent actions against those involved in crime against women, and Honorable President's assent is awarded. Development. Rural infrastructure and other developments. Road connectivity triggers economic growth and facilitates new economic opportunities for people and enterprises. Under Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, between 2020-2024, we intend to lay an additional 3,285 kilometers of roads connecting facilities like agricultural market centers, schools and health centers. A key priority is to enhance productivity of the degraded land to facilitate greater rural employment opportunities and rise in income levels. Towards this, we are focusing on watershed development programs that develop degraded land resources to enhance land productivity. We are also advancing livelihood security through wage employment programs such as MGNREGs. We have implemented the MGNREGs in 12,914 gram panchayats across 661 mandals. Presently, in 2020-21, our state ranks first nationally, generating over 10.68 crore person day of employment as on date. In 2019-20, we have provided employment for more than 23 crore person days. Additionally, we have issued over 62,000 new job cards to migrant laborers. Urban infrastructure. A top priority for us under urban infrastructure development is to provide safe drinking water to all urban local bodies. Water supply improvement schemes are being implemented to bring per capita water supply at par with national standards of 135 MPCD. We have improved supply frequently and per capita access in 5 ULBS. Additionally, 5 water supply schemes have been completed under Amrut, HUDCO and VD SMT projects in 2019-20. In a phased manner, it is proposed to take up sewerage network and separate treatment in 102 ULBS. Water resources. Water is fundamental to life, livelihood, food security, and sustainable development. We are prioritizing water resources management through the Jalagram program. Out of 54 irrigation projects envisaged under the program, 14 have been completed and others are in progress. Pula Subiya Beligonda project, Sangam Barrage, Nellore Barrage, Vasundhara Phase 2, Vasundhara Nagabali Link, Oak Second Tunnel will be completed this year. My government has also accelerated efforts for completion of Polavaram project by December 2021, along with land acquisition, rehabilitation and resettlement. All other ongoing projects will be completed in the next 4 years. My government is initiating steps to take up Raisalama Drought Mitigation Project, speeding up of Uttara Andhra Surjana Shravanti, enhancing the capacity of Polavaram right main canal to 50,000 cubic to take care of Krishna Delta, NHP Aikat, and Dratpun Raisalama Nellore and Prakasham. Energy. My government recognizes that the health of the distribution utilities, DISCOM, is of utmost importance for survival and efficient functioning of the state energy sector. It would not be out of place to mention that owing to the previous government's neglect of the sector and the under-release of subsidy to the DISCOMs, the DISCOMs were forced to borrow heavily to sustain, and this has jeopardized the whole sector. Bearing in mind the need to bail out the sector, my government has provided a huge financial assistance to the tune of rupees 17,904 crores towards not just the current year subsidy component, but also for the sector's dues that pertain to the period of previous government. Another issue of concern is the financial burden of subsidizing agricultural power consumption. The annual agricultural consumption is close to 12,221 MUs for the year 2020-21, leading to a subsidy requirement of close to ₹8,354 crores. Given the yearly increase in agricultural consumption, the subsidy amount is likely to increase to alarming levels during the next few years. Keeping this in mind, my government has come up with a scheme of significantly reducing the average cost of purchasing power that is supplied to agriculture by leveraging on huge solar energy generation potential in the state by developing solar power project on BOT model to the tune of 10,000 MWP. The power from these projects would be adequate for the agricultural consumption and ensure substantially of the sector, as the cost of supply of power would be significantly lower. Industrialization and strategic infrastructure development. We are committed to drive rapid industrialization of our state through competitive industrial policies and investing in strategic infrastructure. We have already hit the ground by initiating the process for clearing ₹4,000 crores of pending industrial incentives of the previous government, signaling our commitment. To encourage new industrial investment, we'll release a new industrial policy very soon. We have allotted land to more than 1,466 companies through APIAC. This represents a committed investment of INR 11,548 crores. 39 large and mega industries have cumulatively invested even more INR 24,000 crores, generating almost 36,810 jobs. 13,122 MSMEs have started operation, investing more than INR 2,500 crores and generating about 63,897 jobs. To position MSMEs for growth, we have launched the YSR Navodayam scheme for a one-time restructuring of MSMEs loans. Being an agrarian state, we are tremendous opportunity to leverage our agricultural resources, using them for higher values, addition activities and job creation. Hence, we consider food processing a priority industrial sector. We plan to introduce a new food processing policy. A key feature will be setting up new food processing zones in each parliamentary constituencies. Strategic economic infrastructure will facilitate accelerated economic growth. My government is striving to build and strengthen infrastructure that enhances trade. We are striving to operationalize to major industrial corridors, namely Visakhapatnam Chennai Industrial Corridor and the Chennai Bengaluru Industrial Corridor. Corridor development will strengthen connectivity and existing industries such as textile, pharma, food processing, and also allow for setting up of new ones. We are expanding construction of the Bhogapuram International Airport in Vijayanagaram and completion of airport at Urvukulu, Kurnool. We have already entered into an ₹2,300 crore partnership agreement with JMR Airport Limited to develop the Bhogapuram Airport. Our state has the second longest coast stretching 974 kilometers. We see an opportunity to transform our state into a maritime trading hub for Southeast Asia. We intend to strengthen our 6 post ports and taking up construction of 3 new ports at Ramayapatam, Machalipatam and Bhavanapattu. 8 fishing harbors will be constructed in 3 years at a cost of ₹3,200 crores. Corruption-free governance. My government is firmly committed to clean and corrupt-free governance and has taken several measures to achieve it. Reverse tendering for public works has resulted in savings of around ₹2,200 crores. Under the Spandana initiative, any citizen can register a complaint about corrupt practices by public servants. The complaints are then transferred to the Anti-Corruption Bureau for redressal. COVID. My government has been taking effective steps to contain the spread of COVID-19 and stand ahead of other states in the number of tests conducted. From just one lab, my government has increased the number of testing labs to 13. About 15,000 tests are being conducted per day, and it tops the national average among the states by conducting over 5.5 lakh tests and more than 10,000 tests per million. The mortality rate is much lower than that of national average, and the recovery rate is highest than national average. There are 5 dedicated COVID-19 hospitals, and the district 65 hospitals are dedicated for corona patients. We have 38,000 isolation beds, 15,000 equipped with oxygen supply, and 5,400 ICU beds, of which 1,300 have ventilator facilities. About 24,000 doctors and 24,500 paramedical staff are working round the clock in affected areas, and we have demarcated red, green and orange zones as per requirements of the containment strategy. Our village ward volunteers, staff of village ward secretariats, medical personnel, police, municipal staff, revenue, electricity and other staff have done a wonderful job and stood in the front line in containing the spread of COVID-19. During the lockdown, essential commodities including additional rations of 5 kg rice per head and 1 kg dal per card, 2 times a month along with one-time assistance of rupees 1,000 were delivered to households. To address the migrant labour's issue, my government set up over 400 relief centres to help provide food, shelter and basic amenities to over 1.2 lakh migrant workers. APRST buses and Shramik special trains were utilized to transport over 3.2 lakh stranded workers to their homes, both in AP and in other states, free of cost. Free food was provided to the workers while they were on the road. Workers returning to their homes in a rural Andhra Pradesh are being provided additional MGNREJ jobs to help them on an income. My government has spent rupees 2,200 crore towards market intervention and purchased agricultural production from farmers during COVID and facilitated in exports marine. The volunteers have conducted 4 rounds of household survey and we followed the norm of trace, test and treat is still going on. My government firmly believe that we have to live with corona in the coming days and have opened up economy, keeping the safety rooms as the wheels of economy have to roll on. All these measures have helped Andhra Pradesh achieve a low mortality rate, a low positivity rate, and a much higher recovery rate than most of the states. Legislations. My government has legislated path-breaking laws which will usher in social, economic and political justice in the strictest sense. We have brought in a law setting up backward commission on a permanent basis and have provided 50% reservation to SC, ST, BC and minorities in a nominated post and nominated works and in all temple governing councils coming under the endowment department. Providing 75% reservation to locals is another landmark legislation made by my government and introduced skill development to churn our skill workforce. The important legislation my government has brought in introducing English medium from primary level as children from weaker sections study in government schools and will be at a disadvantage when they pass out of the school. This is to increase the enrollment ratio and to make them globally competitive. Though there are some hurdles, they will be cleared soon as 97% of the parents are wishing that their words study in English medium. My government has also brought in legislation to regulate the private school and colleges which are not up to the set guidelines and standards. A judicial preview commission has been formed throughout a legislation wherein all tenders above rupees 100 crores will undergo scrutiny by a retired High Court judge and will be finalized by the Commission. Through reverse tendering, nearly 2,100 crores was saved, which shows the sincerity of the government. The Land Titling Act will put a check on irregularities in land registration and put an end to land disputes. Disha Bill is historic legislation as it provides for a speedy trial and conviction within 21 working days, which deals with crime against women. To deal with atrocities against women and children, 18 Disha police stations have been set up. Dedicated special courts are being set up. We have amended the State Prohibition and Excise Act, giving in more teeth to implement reduce consumption of liquor. We would close down 43,000 belt shops and shut down 4,300 permit rooms and reduced the timing of sale while increasing the price to reduce the consumption of alcohol. Due to above efforts, results are visible with reduction in consumption of alcohol. We have merged the APSRTC with the government through a law taking in 51,400 employees into newly created Public Transport Department. Decentralization of administration has been the key principle based on which the legislation is in process to have a three capitals concept. Under this concept, Amaravati will be the legislative capital, while Visakhapatnam will be the executive capital, and Kurnool will be the judicial capital. While concluding, my government hopes that better days will come and the life goes on smoothly. To sum up, my government has done exceptionally well in social justice and bringing welfare schemes to the intended sections. Brought in sweeping reforms in administration, improved the healthcare system manifold, instilled confidence among the farmers, has taken measures to revamp school and hospitals. All sections are touched through the welfare and developmental schemes, and I hope this year will be still better. Joy.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड़ उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे